I'm going to be hopefully in the Hogan stand. The usual scramble for tickets is on. And the people I feel sorry for are the people who went to all of the rounds, the Connacht Championship, the quarter final, the semi final, and unfortunately, because of the demand for tickets, will not be able to be at a very historic occasion, because we've never had since 1948 two teams, one from the North, one from Connacht, against each other, pitted against each other in the All-Ireland final. The atmosphere in Mayo, strangely enough, is very calm, and it's far more mature than in previous ventures into Croke Park. And I think what has also happened, which could rebound to Mayo's advantage, is that everybody is writing them off. We saw Donegal, I mean, the pace, the organisation, they attack in droves and in waves. They're a team that's physically hugely strong and very, very fast. So we're hoping that James Horden will, in his own way, have devised some kind of a plan to counter the kind of style and the football that Donegal play. The one thing I admire about Donegal this year, as against last year when they were criticised for being overly defensive, they really play a 14-man game. They disregard the numbers completely. It's one for all and all for one, right from number one, the goalkeeper, right up to the full forward and the corner forward, number 15. So we're looking forward to a very historic occasion.
What message would you like to give to the Mayo team for Sunday?
Well, I've been at the training session on Friday last, and I can tell you that they certainly seemed to have worked out in their own way a pattern of play that will counteract Donegal. The message I'll give to the Mayo team is this: I think the first 10 minutes are absolutely vital, and of course the last 10 minutes are going to be the decisive factor. So get in, get stuck in at the start, and ensure that you get ahead, because I have a funny feeling that Donegal have won most of their games so comprehensively that if Mayo get off to a good start against them, well, what the media are saying may not in fact come to pass.